10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Expirations
turn to pick.
I Bad Rider gonna have such an easy time against the both of them. Like, even with Slardar there, it's still pretty difficult for them to deal with the Bat Rider.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Timber Saw!
We'll have to wait and see. I'm really interested to see how they run this. This is not a hero that we see too often. And, you know, even though she used to be, like, very, very popular and people got bored of watching her, fell off, and here she is again. So it's always entertaining to see new heroes in the patch.
This draft is that they already are showing Shadow Demon, which I'm not sure if you guys remember this interaction, but you disrupt the Spectre, Soul Catcher, and you Demonic Purge. Your two illusions that you get from Spectre will both have Desolate. You, as a support, you could solo kill Spectre, like, once you have that Soul Catcher maxed out. So this is a risky pick nonetheless here by Miracle, but, you know, he's playing it, he has confidence. I'm actually going to quickly check out this talent tree, because this is my first time seeing Spectre in a new patch. We got a 5
armor.
I played it,
just and recently. The Spectral Dagger cooldown is kind of...
Okay, so instead of the 400 health, yeah?
I would say that the 400 health is better, but I mean, obviously it's not as interesting as minus 10 second on Spectral Dagger, and the dagger just allows you to, like, go in and out all over the place.
It's so funny because it lasts 7 seconds as well, right? So you
have 100% of time.
Yeah. Okay. I could imagine one team fight where it's just like going crazy, where you did like everyone's walking on those black, what do you call that, ink? Black shadow thing. Everyone slow down and the ground's all black. But it seems like her other talent trees are very boring. It's like flat stuff.
Yeah, it's just all passives.
I guess you could be super tanky if you take like 5 armor, 6 stat, 12 strength, 400 health. Like you could become the tankiest Spectre of all time, which might be what Miracle is looking to do this game.
They're asking for server change.
To Japan. A bunch of Hinoi, Singaporeans, Malaysians not playing in C. Never mind, go. So Gabby is going to be playing the mid Timber. EJ playing the carry. And then we got what? Gabby loves A playing Bat Rider. I mean, he's a stand in, so maybe they are adjusting 40 stand in. That's very likely. Because I don't think the carry player is there today.
Okay, that makes more sense. Yeah. We already know that DJ's playing offlane for Execration.
Yep.
Pride and true early level 1 smoke, the enemy jungle.
This is a very weird level 1 smoke, right? Batrider's showing himself, but they're not going to run into anybody. And when you pick such a weak carry like a Spectre, are you almost inviting an offensive trialing against you?
I would say in this case, yeah. Because your supports aren't exactly the strongest either.
Uh-huh. Well, I think that's what we're going to see here as Execration is leaving behind 3 heroes. Batrider now roaming back mid. No, he's going to go up top. So it's as we expect. We're going to see essentially Miracle just getting absolutely wrecked. The last time I've seen him getting wrecked so hard in the lane, team just lost like in 15 minutes. So this is not a hero that could afford to have a bad early game, honestly.
I think he's gonna notice. I think he should see the heroes with the ward, and probably just switch TP and TP up.
Yeah. Okay. Well, Rubick is making no movement. Rubick is gonna spend his time to actually do the ancient pull in the mid lane. So Miracle's on his own, man.
I guess he's sacrificing himself then.
Okay.
Not gonna be a rotation because he can't reach the shop anymore.
I'm gonna watch Ninja Boogie do this pull. It's always so sweet to see. There you go.
P.
Yeah. I wonder why or when they're gonna start fixing that. It was extremely game breaking.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Spectre is not gonna be doing anything for a very long time. Oh, he's trying to reach the shop.
Oh,
he might die for this.
Oh no. Okay, dagger? No, he's fine. He's in the trees.
but now you're in an even worse position. Now he can't even leech from the lane because
it's okay. He's got another dagger.
Where's the other dagger?
All right, he's gonna eat through. Okay, that's fine too. I mean, I think it's okay. They're winning mid because of the pull, and they're likely winning top. Although Gabby loves A is getting a ton of experience.
It's definitely expected. Not much you can do.
Oh,
they want to go
top
for the gank.
Search for jewels here. They lift him up and toss him back, and Ninja Boogie's gonna find the first blood with the Fable. This is a very interesting way of playing things, right? Like, they're consciously sacking Miracle, and apparently they're okay with it.
Very surprising.
Saying Rubick, you stay up top. I think Rubick staying up top is the right choice because only Rubick by himself changes how this lane goes.
Yeah, definitely. Well, you don't need to keep him top. Go back to mid lane. Ancient pull.
Yeah. I want to say you only could do it like once because those patch of trees are important. Never really sat there and did it endlessly. When I say that though, we're gonna see.
Doing it.
Yep.
Yeah, one ancient creep is a lot.
There you go.
Wait. It only got the range creep.
That's what I mean. You need the trees. Unless you like physically aggro the hits on you. But it's fine. A range creep deny is still pretty good. Miracle is level 2.5. Okay. Not too bad.
Getting something at least.
Yeah. I don't think he's even walked up to a creep yet.
He hasn't left the side of the jungle or the trees. This ward is actually helping him stay alive, though. You can see when the supports are trying to catch him out.
Yeah. And it's actually so hard to kill him. He just, like, daggered through the trees. What are you gonna do?
And he's gone again.
Yeah.
This is so clowny.
I'm surprised he didn't have a Quelling Blade, though. It feels like a Quelling Blade is very important for this kind of playstyle. Although maybe he just doesn't want to take down any trees.
Yeah, I don't think he wants to cut down the trees.
I'm surprised Kunkka hasn't bought a Quelling Blade. Just like go ham on the trees.
I'm gonna catch him. See him.
He's got dagger again. Oh, disruption. Soul catcher.
That happened, because he already died. No, so he...
Oh my goodness. Redefining how the carry role should be played.
Hiding in trees.
Yeah. Staying in trees, man. In terms of the farm go, Luna farming the best, as you would expect. Puck keeping up very well in the mid lane. And Darkseer obviously farming extremely well as well. Gabby really laying down the harass here against the Jay. Jay does have an invis room, but even with this level 6, I don't think he can solo kill Gabby unless like two people rotate in. Looks like we have Ninja Boogie rotating to the bottom lane, but as I mentioned earlier, I don't think this changes the outcome of anything.
Well, the lane is pushing in right now, so Mineski needs to get ready to rotate. I don't think you want to. Okay, never mind. They're just gonna go for the pole instead.
Yep, more creeps are denied. Meanwhile, up
they need
top
to wait.
Here. Yeah.
They need to wait for Puck to hit, and then they make the rotation, and then start making space for a Miracle.
Yeah, but you have a level 3 Spectre with no mana and dagger because he spent it all. And he's then you have a level 3
Rewand with... charges. Enough, eventually. Oh, he's got a huge wave coming in, and I don't think they're going to be able to kill him.
Yeah, he's actually quite tanky, like with that magic stick. I think any tower dive.
Full health too.
Kunkka's gonna rotate in, but so is gonna be a TP in from Jules, perhaps expecting a dive to be coming really, really soon.
I just realized Jules is level 5.
Yeah, man. He's actually the highest level on his team. Oh, not compared to the book. He's higher level than the Darkseer for somehow. Looks like we're gonna see him make a go here. Jules gonna get a clap off, and all of a sudden they just turn around and kill. I really like that TP with the Iron Shell on him. And Miracle
did a lane swap.
Yeah, hitting creeps for the first time. I think doing the lane swap is correct for the side of Execration because I felt like they pretty much done all they needed to do to slow down Miracle. And the Batrider coming in will also slow him down pretty hard.
Yeah, I think they kind of realized that they're in the top lane. DJ's gonna go down here. Nice rotation from the puck.
What did they realize?
They realize that Puck is, so the off lane is no longer safe for them because they can easily just rotate him in, and then they send him to the safe lane, and you know, next thing you know, he just gets ganked anyways. The supports weren't there with them.
You rotate that lane, you want to rotate at least 2 people, I think. Illudium by herself, not very tanky.
Or at least, you know, get some information for your lane. There's like no wording or anything.
Well, so far, I gotta say, this Shadow Demon Kunkka combination hasn't really done much. I mean, they have kept a Miracle down, which is important, but I think Mineski is quite okay with the exchange. I feel like these two needed to kill maybe Darkseer or Slaughter a couple of times, but they've been pretty much pinned to the bottom lane.
Yeah, that lane ward that Miracle put just made it so easy for them to know exactly where they were and sack their mid lane and the mid lane was fine because Timber isn't going to die, but their safe lane suffered heavily because their supports were kind of pinned down here to keep the Spectre down.
Yep, they're trying to make a smoke gank up top here for R, but R is going to just double Iron Shell, push out the wave, and most likely head into the jungle to farm a little bit more. Gabby is going to rotate
Timber
as well.
Too.
It's a 4-man rotation. Okay, well.
Bottom lane? Going on.
Tossing back?
That.
Yeah, Batrider is most likely gonna go down. I say that though, he's going over the trees, but Miracle is chasing. Salve is gonna pop up. He's probably gonna pop the shrine as well. Yeah, it's gonna be fine.
That was really close, because Miracle has 3 in dispersion. Probably he was trying to kill him with his own Firefly.
Right. You can make the argument that if he had a point in Desolate, though, he might have actually gotten the kill. He did get a couple of right clicks in. Gabby coming back in, but Invis J with the Iron Shell on top here. Ooh, that's going to be a 2-3-man Coil if he wants it. Uh-oh, Coil, Silence, Waning Rift. EJ doing a lot of work here. Torrent coming up. It will hit on the Puck here, but Puck taking a ton of damage to ZFA's. He's taking a ton. Coil's going to get used. They stun him up as well, and now Gabby all of a sudden might be in a little bit of trouble here. Gabby might not break the Coil. It's gonna just walks off. Ninja Boogie comes in as well. They're trying to nuke him down, but he's so damn tanky. Jules looking for yet another stun. Meanwhile, on the back line here, RR has overstayed his welcome. Did go down. 1-for-1 exchange.
That was almost perfect for Mineski, but unfortunately for Jay, he just didn't have enough mana for his coil.
I'm surprised that RR went so deep instead of killing the Timber. Like, he went for, I think, the Luna instead.
Yeah, probably just a little bit of miscommunication. I think he probably assumed that the rest of his team was going to be able to kill off the by themselves.
Right. And it looked pretty close, but it's always the case against Timber, looking pretty close. Once again, we're going to see this Iron Shell TP bottom, but that Rider senses it coming. Looks like he's going to be going for the drums build. Dire's
top tower is under attack. I wasn't sure if Miracle at level 60 up too, but it might have been able to use Haunt as well, but
yeah,
I wasn't too sure.
We don't know what his mana situation is either, so one of those things where maybe he could have pawned it, but no mana to come in. I mean, he's also like Spectre haunts him without any points into Desolate, like actually doesn't do much, right? He's got 2 point in Dagger, 0 point in Desolate.
That's a very defensive.
Yeah. He's going for Vanguard first, none of that phase boost stuff either, so. This is not the Batman Spectre that we expect, the max Desolate no matter what. This is I'm gonna take you on to a 80 minute game kind of Spectre, it feels.
80 minute game? I don't think this game will go 80 minutes.
The playstyle, right? Not the actual time length. Oh. Talked about Jay going for Veil first, but straight up it's gonna be the Blink build. What's your thought on that?
He got it pretty fast though, right? Oh, bottom lane. Quark, yep. Jewels, Lasso. Oh, he actually might still make it.
Yeah, where was the Torrent? Okay, they're gonna wait for the push him back. The fire, he pops a magic stick and he's gonna be fine. And that's a flame break stolen. Yeah, he's okay. Did Kunkka not have Torrent or did he miss? He didn't actually catch it in the fight.
I'm very confused about that too. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I was wondering where it was too. I think it went off at the exact same time got lassoed. I think
probably. As lasso? Like. Okay. Mid lane here, the new damage is coming on. They're gonna try to burst him down. Coil has been used, but he pops the magic stick. He's gonna be fine. Tower is gonna go down. No, denied by Ninja Boogie. Nicely done, but Jules is gonna get absolutely chopped. Great blink away here by Jay. I don't know, multiple times in a row now, they just go on to the Timbersaw. And this very unusual purchase of the Magic Wand. I don't think normally Timber buys a Magic Wand, right? And it's kind of making Mineski overestimate how much damage it can output.
Yeah, I probably agree with that. Normally you see a bottle come out for mid-Timbersaw, but yeah. This Dabby just goes for the hood build.
Yeah.
The Bloodstone. Really, really difficult to kill off. And this is like a really, really good itemization because there's pretty much no physical damage Mineski.
Not until like 40 minutes later. Like Miracle might start
hitting some. Even with the Corrosive Haze, there's not many people who are gonna do too much with the right clicks.
I guess if you want to count in the Darkseer wall, but that's, you know, not very high damage either. Alright, they're gonna try to chase Gabby away, but Gabby with a hood, like, there's just no way. But they are gonna deny a tower. Bottom lane, they want Miracle X to start things off. Warren Bolt, and he's gonna try to disjoint him, but unfortunately, the X marks the spot, it's gonna find him. It lasso him up as well, and there's not much you could do. Miracle's gonna pop the magic stick, gets mech'd up here, he's gonna be fine. The Surge is gonna be on top of him as well, he's running through the trees here. Gabby does not care, but nobody dies. A second X gonna come through, this time it's gonna be on top of Jules. X Torrent's gonna hit, and Jules probably gonna die for Miracle here. And they
have a very amusing attempt to disjoint the X combo.
Yeah. I guess
he realities into like 20 different illusions over and over again.
Yeah. You know what that reminded me? One time I played support Spectre, and my first item was Shivas, right? So every team awful. Fight, I haunt, I pop Shivas, and I just reality off to everywhere. And then it's just like, that Shiva debuff, man, is on top of everyone. But, that's one thing that I wanted to see more pro players do, like the using reality to dodge spells. It's very hard to do because, you know, you don't really get a lot of practice with that kind of stuff. But
yeah, I'm pretty sure the only thing you can do is click on your mini map over and over again.
Yeah, just make them confused, man. What do you think about the Puck skipping Veil? It's so like, you know, 2014, I guess, on the build that he's going for.
I kind of agree with you on Veil being a very good item overall, but to be fair, their team doesn't exactly have like any nuke potential apart from just himself.
Well, here's the thing. Earlier you said they don't have a lot of Miracle. Losing about half his HP, we'll have to just run down the run to stagger, but Gabby is, well, trying to follow. He misses the chain, and Miracle runs away. Earlier you said you don't have, you said they don't have any physical damage. Now they don't have any magical damage.
Well, it's so not that they don't have magical damage, it's just not,
it's not like a
crazy amount.
Disjointing that torrent. But Kunkka with a bolt toss out, he's gonna be fine. Jay's out, Jules is out. RR, walking very slowly, 55 looking for the X here. They pop the drums and they got vision on him. Can they actually get the X? Somehow they did. And RR is gonna be dead here. Wait. Alright, he's actually dead.
In one vacuum.
Yo, he's dead. We got a range drops from it, Worf.
I think a Veil would be very, very worth it if Miracle manages to finish Radiance at a decent time.
Okay. I think if you don't go for Veil in the beginning, you don't go back for a Veil at all.
Yeah, that's also a good point.
You kind of just like worry about other forms of puck items. Blessings
upon a loyal warrior. Maybe he's going for the Dagon build because like he needs like a very reliable way of bursting people down just to make space for Miracle to farm.
Okay.
So I think Dagon is probably just a little more reliable in the sense that you can actually pick off one target better than a Veil can. Someone's gonna have to do the math though. I actually don't really know how much the Veil overall combo, just having a Dagon.
I say the Dagon 1 compared to the Veil might not be as good. Hold that thought here, bottom lane here, we do have that burst. That's a quick kill and Jay is out. Although Kunkka is coming in. I guess one thing that you also want to consider this game is that he wants the Dagon. You think he's gonna like try to go into a Lincoln's or a Yule's later on down the road just to mess with the Kunkka combo?
I think it's really hard to say. I think he's gonna have to go for a pretty snowball-y build, in my opinion.
Okay.
It's just kind of how the game is developing at this point.
It's really pretty much up to him and perhaps the Darkseer Slaughter combination to create a ton of space on the map, which they have been doing. Like Miracle, for not farming essentially for 10 minutes, he's like the fourth highest in net worth, which is pretty impressive if you ask me.
Well, it wasn't that extreme. 10 minutes.
All right,
he pretty much did the lane rotation in about like 7 minutes into the game. They rotated, so he's been farming for about 10 minutes.
Yeah, I know Vanguard. It looks like he's going for a very defensive build, a Strange Treads, and a Vanguard build. Are you surprised at all that we don't see Helm of Dominator? Because sure, it doesn't make you as tanky as a Vanguard would, but you know, you farm the jungle much faster, and you get that extra creep.
I think it's set them back a bit.
Oh, Puck.
It's hard to say.
Well, they want DJ. The Han's gonna come through as well. Defensive Disruption's gonna come out, and that was, I believe, Soul Catcher being stolen. Vacuum back in, and now the Luna Eclipse is gonna do so much damage with the Chakra on top of the Miracle is in there, but I'm not sure what he wants to be. The Lasso is gonna keep Jay locked down. He really wants a Kunkka, and they do get the Dagon kill, but the Chakram cuts down the tree, they ping out Miracle. Miracle trying to run away, he's being slowed down by the Napalm. It looks like he will go down eventually. Maybe he could just straight up TP out, and in fact, he will do so. Meanwhile, the back of the base here, DJ dropping very, very low, but does not die. Does he actually want to farm the wall? This is not the time to do so. That was
definitely
an interesting fight that Mineski wanted to take.
I think they might have overestimated or underestimated just exactly how strong Execration is right now. They fought straight into the Eclipse, right next to a Shrine too. Pretty ambitious attempt.
Although I don't think the Shrine really got used, but people was able to pour it in.
Yeah, just reinforce quickly.
You know what that fight was about for me is the Cocoa Room. Like, there were so many people dropping super low, like DJ in particular, right, towards the end of the fight. If the Cocoa Rum did not hit as many people as it did, I think Mineski will probably run away with that fight.
Yeah, I think that's pretty fair. Because ideally for Mineski's lineup, you don't exactly want to commit into a 5-on-5 fight. You just want to pick someone off with your Puck's Dagon, and then you just run away. One or two heroes, and then you just run away. Take your winnings. If possible.
Yeah. I also wasn't sure whether DJ held his ultimate until the Spectre Illusions were down. I felt like that was the case, because the haunt came out pretty much instantly, and DJ got disrupted, so it was okay for a while.
That's a good point.
I think that's something that Miracle should try to do, like maybe hold the haunt even until he sees Eclipse coming online, because that could just block a ton of that damage output.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
I like this little mechanism from Execration. They X the Timber Saw and he just TP's up top to defend.
And they're putting in a ton of pressure. Oh, Gabby? Gonna get found here. Meanwhile, DJ is gonna steal the stack from the other side. Execration doing quite well, but Mineski is answering back. They are gonna actually get a tier 2 tower essentially for free. Timbersaw's TP being down was a pretty big deal there. But uh-oh, Miracle going into the trees. DJ, did he not see the Rubick?
I kind of surprised too. I think he did, but he did. I think he assumed that he wasn't gonna get it in time.
Yeah. Looked pretty close there if he fired it off.
I actually think he would have been able to easily.
Yeah.
Get it immediately. But I think at this point Mineski just waits for Radiance. Unless they have some smokes, you could probably commit one to make a pickoff or try to go for a pickoff.
It is hard to fight into this lineup that has Batrider and Kunkka. And just protecting your backline, and then Gabby standing in the front, making sure that you can't come in from that angle either. Mineski is just trying their best to go for trades, but this gold graph is gonna widen as we speak.
Top tower Gabby's Timbersaw is, like, her farm.
Yeah. I mean, there's just no answer to him in this game, right?
I don't think I would underestimate the burst potential from Jay's Puck build.
Puck?
Like, he's just pretty much maxing out his Dagon. It's already at level 4, so the amount of damage he outputs is pretty insane. Waves?
Yeah. I don't know if they really need the wave. Seems like... Okay, it looks like they do. Yeah, backdoor protection. Lasso's gonna find Ninja. And the Han's gonna come in. I'm not sure if they actually want to fight this. Coil! That's gonna be at 4! Raining Rift is gonna be falling as well. Back wall on top of that as well. But where's the damage output? Here comes the Eclipse right after the old Miracle dropping. Verilo is gonna try to run away. They ping him out. Meanwhile, Puck's on the high ground. Puck finds Gabby and he's gonna jaunt to the low ground. He should be fine. And now the rest of the team is running off. Man, they need a Slaughter to really follow up as well. But that is as good of a combo as you could ask for. Joe's moving forward using the Iron Shell. Following DJ, he needs a little bit more, but he gets beamed down and DJ turns around. Jules, okay, one more right click. Meanwhile, Puck comes in, he really wants DJ, he wants that Dagon. Blinking forward, they're slowing him down, and he's actually gonna get trapped here. DJ needs to phase, needs to blink. He phased, the Vax gonna find him, but they still can't kill DJ. Puck's gonna be dead on the backline here. And somehow, someone give me that Benny Heath theme music. He dominates
that micro.
He stuns him! Oh my god, the play by DJ though. And now Ninja Buki TP's in with a Shockwave on the backline here. What a chain combo. Ninja Buki now will run away with the Surge. And that means that Darkseer is dead to right as well. He's trying to TP out. He gets X back. And Ninja Buki maybe could have went forward and gotten the kill. But he says, I've seen enough, man. Execration just playing with them.
Oh my god, that was the most disastrous chase I've ever seen.
Yeah.
It's actually really, really bad that they lost the Puck there, but to lose the Darkseer and the Rubick for a second time, what a bait. We're just seeing some top tier baits like today.
I mean, that dominating on this the Rock Golem,
yeah,
oh my
that
god.
That was a really good play. That was a really, really good play.
Because like, I think most people were just like ran in a straight line. And the Mud Golem now chasing in the front line. Okay, Puck coming back in, but Gabby already has his Echo Heal on top of himself, so... I feel like Execration is in a super good spot after that fight, and Miracle died once again in that engagement, right? So that Radiance is further delayed. I can't help but feel that once Mineski does have the Radiant, so these teamfights get much better. Because we see how close these teamfights actually are. And essentially, they're fighting 4v5 right now. Like, Mirko is not...
I definitely agree. Which is why I'm really surprised there are these head-on engagements, even though they don't have the damage from Spectre. Because right now, Spectre doesn't really offer too much, or anything really at all.
Yeah. I guess one thing Spectre is doing is allowing the puck to set up. Generally, when you haunt like that, like, people are grouped up to not taking the desolate damage, or they're running away in a single direction, single file. We saw that allow the vacuum combo, the Darkseer, sorry, the puck combo to go off, but it's not enough.
Right now, his main goal in these team fights is pretty much just to soak up the damage, the AoE damage from Execration, like Eclipse Beams and Timber Saw and Firefly, and just disperse all of it.
And
pretty
DJ
much
once...
the extent of his damage right now.
DJ once again just holds his Eclipse till the ults are over, and you know, prior to give maximize damage output. Looks like Puck is gonna be going for the Lincoln Sphere.
Ooh, kind of interesting to see Hurricane Pike is the next item for Luna. Normally, I just see Lunas keep the Dragon Lance, and then you go for something like BKB, next Butterfly.
It makes sense, right? It seems like they're trying to kill the Luna pretty hard by chasing him over and over again. And against the Spectre, I think Hurricane Pike is a very fine item choice.
Creation going for Roshan. This doesn't look like there's even an attempt to just stop them from this.
Yep.
I think Mineski is just committed to the idea of waiting for Radiance until their next team fight.
Yeah, they kind of have to. I mean, they've lost all their outer towers, so Spectre Gaming or bust. But I'm not sure whether they're gonna get the time. 800 gold is a lot of time, man. Maybe he needs to sell like his Ring of Aquila or something to get that last bit. Because here comes the Execration. Not sure if putting the Iron Shell Miracle helps either.
<It's> like I was
missing
say.
Missing a couple of last hits there.
Sorry, he only missed one.
Okay.
I think he'll sell his Quelling Blade. He's gonna farm this wave, sell his Quelling Blade, buy a TP, farm the next wave, and then buy Radiance.
Alright, let's all watch Miracle not miss a single asset here.
What's he
selling? He needs a courier at the shop!
No, he's gonna buy it from the Dire
Enemy ship, okay.
Okay, so he sold his wand, so he does have enough now.
But he doesn't have a TP. Oh, okay, he's gonna haunt it, obviously. Yeah. Alright.
So he's got it. Go.
Well, the wall has already been deployed. Power is taking a ton of damage. RR thinking about coming back in, but Gabby?
I have the vacuum.
Okay, Disruption's gonna get used a second time here. They need to do something right now. Blink.
Alright, here we go.
Ahn's gonna come through right now. Where is he going? I think he's trying to go on the back line. He finds 55, but 55's gonna pop the X, pop the mech for himself. Mirko soaking up a ton of damage. They're pinging him out. They're focusing him. Where is his team? Mirko just dies. No buyback, obviously, because he's just finished the Radiance. R is gonna get hit up by the Flame Break. He's gonna get chained down here as well. And the rest of Mineski. I didn't see where Jay was, but he definitely did not use any of his spells. Now he comes in, kills the Kunkka. He does have the Shadow Demon trapped in, but I don't think they care. They're now just gonna focus on the rest of the building. They lift up DJ, but DJ still has Aegis. But he's gonna be fine. Gabby's gonna come back in. Ninja Boogie's dropping extremely low. And okay, they finally removed the Aegis. Ninja Boogie's trying to pop the shrine, but he's gonna be dead. And the rest of the Execration could just back out for free. Which I think that's exactly what they're gonna do.
That was a very, very surprising from Mineski. It's like you said, Miracle jumps the back line, but where's the rest of his team? They were just all completely zoned out by the Timbersaw.
I'm also very surprised when Jules hit his Blink Crush that Darkseer didn't follow up with the vacuum or something like that. It almost felt like Jules jumped the gun without communicating with his team, and then Miracle went in, and then everyone was on their own page. It felt like that. I'm not sure if it was like that, but...
I mean, to be fair though, his Crush was pretty good. He got Luna and the Timbersaw. So there wasn't really a setup that was needed.
I was gonna say he got a whole bunch of the illusions as well.
But yeah, but I mean, he still ended up catching out the Timber and the Luna, which should be
okay,
more than enough, especially with like Haunt revealing where everyone else is. I think they should have just made the fight as chaotic as possible. Maybe the Puck could have just jumped in the back line and killed lots of supports with the Miracle. And they kind of just like, you know, circle in onto them.
Here comes the important question. Is one Rax enough?
Well, they're about to make it too if they don't manage to hold this. I think if they hold this, it could be... This game could be delayed, but if they lose the second Rax, I think it's only a matter of time before Execration end this game.
Well, they gotta go now, and these Glaives are preventing. Here comes the Haunt again. Okay, the Bolt's gonna come through. Here comes Shields on the back line. Here comes Puck as well. They Dagon one down. There's the back wall combination. And then what? Okay, the Batrider gets lifted on the back line as well. Jules is going to die under the shotgun. The Batrider is still alive. The mech's going to come through. There's a buyback from the Slaughter. And now I think Mineski is looking to chase here. DJ's dropping very low. He does not have the Aegis anymore. The shotgun's going to cover the retreat. Miracle under the shotgun. Taking a ton of damage. And he's going to go down, I believe. But no, Jill comes back in, helping out his carry. And now Gabby might have overstayed his welcome. Miracle still hangs around, threatening to dagger a little bit more. Jules taking a ton of that shotgun damage. That Agon Scepter doing so much work. They still want Gabby, but the Ray Boss is a little bit too strong. They have successfully defended. Slaughter did have to use the buyback, but a defense is a defense. And now they're giving some time for those, the Glyph to cool down, very importantly. And Miracle, for the first time in a long time, does not die in a defense. He will have Yasha for the next fight.
That EXP swing and that gold swing from one team fight. That's the situation they're in right now. They win another team fight like that. I think Mineski definitely have what it takes to win this in the late game.
But I'm not sure whether they're going to have the cooldown. First of all, looks like Miracle's going to get ganked. He doesn't have a TP. He's going to get found here. He might have to spend his buyback. He doesn't actually have buyback goal either. Okay, Disruption's going to come through. Miracle looking to fight here. The Bolt's going to come in his way. Miracle's still alive somehow. He's still alive, but looks like he's going to go... Okay, he finally dies. And now Gabby still doing Gabby things. Jay's gonna blink back out. I think without Miracle here, they can't hold.
I think you're right, too. They're doing their best, but Gabby, Raid Boss, how do you stop him?
He has not died this game. 10-0-8 is the score. Bloodstone up to 24. Blink Crush on the back line. They do find themselves a Kunkka. Blink Silence. Dagon, perhaps? Silence Dagon. Okay, that's a kill. That helps a lot. Without the Kunkka mech, I don't think they're going to be as confident pushing in. I say that though, DJ already popped the Shadow Demon Luna combination, and Jules finds yet another clap on the back line. He wants a Shadow Demon, but Jules being slowed down. He needs a surge, and he will get the surge off. He takes a ton of damage, but the mech's going to keep him alive. And time is of essence, and they're buying a ton of it. Somehow Mineski, they are holding.
Yeah, these pickoffs are very, very important to them right now. I think killing off that Kunkka is crucial. He offers so much to these team fights, and without the Kunkka, Execration just aren't confident these high ground pushes.
Shadow Demon. Puck's gonna jaunt to the right side here, and he's gonna jump away. Looks like the Lincoln Sphere blocked the lasso, so very nicely done.
This is space creation at its finest.
Yep.
Jay's gonna have to do this for the next like 15 minutes just so Miracle can farm up items to carry.
I mean, honestly, all Mineski needs is one decisive team fights, right? Which they still have not had yet. They had glimpses of very good coordination, but it's always a bit short. It looks like we're gonna see Execration grouping him again. This time, Butterfly online on DJ. When Mineski looking to fight this, they see DJ in the front line. They need to get the Shadow Demon in the back. The Haunt's gonna come through. The Disruption has already been committed. Blink back.
The Disruption's awful down now,
too. Out the retreat here, and that's gonna be a kill. Meanwhile, on the front here, it's gonna be Jay finding a coil on only one, and Shadow Demon's getting gained upon as well here. Jules looking for the kill. The Iron Shell will get the kill, and that's Batrider that's dead as well. That was the decisive team fight that we're looking for. Mineski finds a big one, and all of a sudden, despite being down one full set of racks, they're now actually looking to move forward, checking out Roshan. It is going to be a slowish spawn. I don't think they're going to stay here for a minute. And Miracle will probably just go back and farm top.
Oh man, that graph, it's climbing. It's going the other way. It's actually happening.
Yeah.
Still though, they still have to deal with this raid boss, Gabby. And I don't think they don't exactly have enough still. Even, like, he's just so tanky. Physical and magic damage both don't really harm him in any way. Look at that damage he does.
I mean, he does do a lot of damage, but it seems like Mineski is not really worried about him right now. They're okay just leaving him alive throughout the team fight. It seems like they want the Shadow Demon, they want the Kunkka, and they want the Luna. And like, yeah, sure, you could have your Batrider and your Timbersaw alive. It seems to be the way that Mineski is taking these fights. Oh my god! Jay, forced to pop his ultimate. Just to survive here from Gabby.
It's not even that they're okay with leaving him, it's just that they have to take a team fight without focusing on him,
okay.
Yeah, because they don't have a choice. Like, there's no way you're going to win a team fight if you focus the Timbersaw first.
Alright, we're going to try one more time here by Execration. They even pop the smoke here. Smoking behind Gabby.
This is kind of what they have to do.
Yep.
Down behind your wall. Great wall of Gabby.
Checking on buyback status. Puck does have one. And Rubick has one. But that's pretty much it. The Ranger Racks will go down. And it seems like they are not looking to defend the Melee Racks either. Puck doing what he can. But Jules getting caught out. The Haunt's going to come through right now. And Eclipse on the back line. Jules' HP evaporates instantly. Okay, back wall is going to get dropped here. Where's the Spectre in all of this? I'm not too sure Spectre now in the back line. But they pretty much wasted their entire combination. And everybody's at full HP on the side of Execration. Keep in mind that's a dieback on the... Ooh, Ninja Boogie taking a ton of damage. Looks like he'll be okay getting searched back out. Gabby just takes the full-on frontal assault by the side of Mineski and just does not care. Now Puck comes back in. He wants to Dagon down DJ. DJ dropping low and Jay still jaunting and phasing around. DJ hanging around the coil. Breaks the coil. It's very low and the Radiance is actually burning him down. Meanwhile, Puck might be a little bit of trouble. He phased. I believe he has Blink available. Oh no, he has a turn, but he will jaunt out. No, the Torrent finds him. That is going to be a buyback. Gabby is still on the front line. I mean, the base is quote-unquote defended, but that's, you know, a couple more kills going into the pocket of DJ.
I don't even know if you can consider that a defense. That was like buybacks, all your cooldowns, and you still lost the range racks, and your melee racks is down to a third. If they decide to just push again, I don't know if you can hold.
Well, Roche is back up right now, and if they give it to DJ, that is going to be absolutely huge. I think that's going to be essentially the final fight for Mineski. They need to win that fight, or that will be the final fight.
Like, not enough damage. It has to come from huge combo. Like, if they don't hit this combo, there's absolutely no way they're going to do enough damage.
Well, so
we're
going
to have to keep an eye out for this Darkseer. A lot of this just relies on Darkseer.
You know, his job is so hard. Even though he has a blink, the glaives are just bouncing so much. And of course, sometimes Shadow Demon just randomly dominates, you know, one of Miracle's illusions. And then, you know, you have Radiance to worry about. It looks like it's going to be DJ picking up that Aegis. So he will have Aegis, Butterfly, Manta, and more importantly, a Hurricane Pike, which you mentioned that we don't see too often. But he's going to have it this game. Mineski still wants to fight into this. Haunt's gonna come back out. They see 55, I think. 55 X's himself. I'm not sure what that X is about. Oh my god, is this gonna be a juke? No, he just straight up dies. Batrider hovering over the trees. And now they want to fight this. Kunkka's gonna port right in. Okay, they actually break the lasso. And now Jay getting caught out. Jay's gonna get absolutely blown
Eye
up.
Back.
Yep, he's not gonna have any way to join the fight for 100 seconds. Ninja Boo's gonna get caught. He's also dead. Now what? Haunt's on cooldown as well here. Jules popping his BKB, trying to do what he can, but it's going to be retreat from Mineski, trying to run away from this team. Good luck. Miracle's going to TP out. Jules could blink out, and now Aura walks away. Okay. 55 unable to actually find anybody. They just called GG.
They just called GG. There's no way they can fight this. All right, this Gabby Timbersaw. What a beast.
Yeah. I felt like Mineski kind of made a lot of strategic errors. For example,